Is it possible that a popular party drug could now be on the cutting edge of treating depression? Stay tuned and find out. Hello, my name is Douglas Bloch. I'm an author and depression survivor. Welcome to your Depression Recovery Channel, where each week we talk about practical tools and coping strategies for healing from depression and anxiety. The title of today's video is Ketamine, the parting drug that can heal depression. And before we start, I clear my throat, but even after that, we have to begin with our normal joke. And, you know, as I speak at the beginning of 2019, Amazon.com is all a rage. Everybody's getting supplies from there. It's amazing. But my kitty, Bruce, you know, many of you have seen him, does not want to order online. Do you know why? He prefers the catalog. I don't hear anybody laughing. Bruce liked that joke. All right. So what if I told you that a psychedelic drug, party drug, was now on the cutting edge of treating depression? That seems rather far-fetched, right? But it's not science fiction. In fact, it's true. How do I know this? Well, I was perusing the internet the other day, and I found this article in Time Magazine called New Hope for Depression. And there's a little picture of Time Magazine right there. It says the antidepressant. Anyway, the point is that ketamine in this article is described as something that people are looking into very seriously, mainly because 30 to 40% of the people out there don't respond to traditional antidepressants. And ketamine is getting so much traction right now that Columbia University opened a ketamine clinic, and now the king of psychiatric hospitals, Menninger Clinic in Houston, Texas, has done the same. Now, what exactly is ketamine? Well, ketamine is an anesthesia medicine. It got its start in the 1960s and was really popular on the Vietnam battlefields because even though it sedates you, it doesn't completely knock you out. So soldiers who are wounded could maneuver off the fields while they were pain-free or at least pain-reduced. Now, in addition to providing sedation, ketamine alters your sense of sight and sound, which is why it has been used as a party drug for many, many years. Actually, it has a nickname called Special K. Now, it's quite interesting that ketamine has only been approved by the FDA as an anesthetic. However, like one-third of all medications out there, it's used for off-label purposes. For example, Seroquel, which is antipsychotic, helps people sleep. Well, ketamine is also being used to treat depression. And I found out about this a decade ago. I was watching a PBS documentary called Depression Out of the Shadows. It was in 2008. And they were just beginning to do trials. And there was this guy, I'll never forget it. He was horribly, horribly depressed. I mean, he looked like he was almost a corpse. He goes into this infusion. He gets it for 20 minutes. He comes out of it and he's beaming and smiling. And he says to the reporter, "You know what? Not only do I feel good, I don't even remember what it was like to be depressed." All this happened in 20 minutes. Now, the Time Magazine article I referred to calls ketamine the most important discovery in treating depression in nearly a half a century. This is because, unlike most antidepressants that take 4 to 6 weeks to be felt, ketamine often takes effect in 1 to 2 weeks, and as I just told you in this anecdote, the same day. Now, this is extremely important for people who come in for treatment who are suicidal, and I mean really suicidal, like I'm ending my life today, because what ketamine does, because it helps people so quickly feel better, is it can help that person postpone the decision and not act immediately or impulsively. And suicide often is an impulsive decision. And, you know, once you're feeling better on the ketamine, you come down and life can look really different. Exactly how ketamine achieves such rapid results is not fully understood, but scientists believe it involves two pathways in the brain. The first pathway involves a neurotransmitter called glutamate. And glutamate is what's called an excitatory neurotransmitter. So what ketamine does is it blocks the reuptake of the glutamate so more of it is available. And this probably is why people feel, you know, better so quickly. The second pathway by which ketamine works is even more important. It seems to increase the amount of something called the brain-derived neurotrophic factor, or BDNF, which is the brain's repair inducer. Now, ketamine not only increases BDNF, but also the sites to which BDNF attaches onto, the receptor sites. So Over time, you get more neuroplasticity or change in the brain and faster repair. One of the most important ways that ketamine is being used right now is to help people with PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. Now, normally if you try to re-experience a trauma, it can be so emotionally charged as to be unbearable. But what ketamine does in its analog as an anesthetic is it allows you to basically relive the moment, but with less pain. And when that happens, people can process what goes on and work through it. This is why we're seeing a lot of new evidence of ketamine-assisted psychotherapy. It's being used more and more by therapists who are helping their patients with PTSD. Now, in doing this research on ketamine, the only real downside I found was its cost. First of all, to have maximum effects, it has to be done with an IV drip, and only certain clinics can do that. A typical session will last 45 minutes to 2 hours, and usually it's $500 a session, and they usually recommend 8 to 12 sessions. You can see how that can really increase the cost. Now, because it's only approved as an anesthetic by the FDA, most insurance companies will not, will not cover it, or they don't cover it up until now anyway. And so what some clinicians are trying to do is after 2 to 4 weeks of these treatments, they give people these sublingual lozenges that have some ketamine in it, and that tries to kind of extend the effect further down the road. However, some good breaking news, as they say in CNN, Kaiser Permanente, that great HMO all over the country in Northern California, is just beginning ketamine trials, which means if they find that it works, they're going to start covering ketamine. Insurance company Kaiser will do that, and if they do so, other insurance companies might follow. And here's some final good news. The Food and Drug Administration is now reviewing a new drug application for a nasal spray called esketamine. This would work simply by spraying it up your nose and having it absorbed in the body this way. Wow, a lot less time and money than getting infusions. If you want to learn more about the cutting edge stuff that's happening with ketamine, I highly recommend you go to a website called the Ketamine Advocacy Network, I think that is called. Yeah, Ketamine Advocacy. I can't even pronounce it right, but you know what I mean. Anyway, so they have a lot of cool news about it. And we'll have it up on the screen for you to see. In the meantime, if you do want to try out ketamine, please don't do it on your own. Remember, one of our cardinal rules, if you're depressed, don't self-medicate. Simply have your psychiatrist or your doctor give you a referral, and hopefully there'll be a ketamine clinic in your area. And if any of you have used it before or are about to use it, please write me. You can leave a comment in the comments section, or you can write me, douglasbloch@gmail.com. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it informative. And I can tell you right now, I'm excited about this new treatment. 3 years ago, as I was about to do ECT, if I had known about ketamine or had access to it, I probably would have tried that first. In the meantime, again, thank you for watching this video. If you'd like to subscribe, which I hope you do, during the closing credits, click on my photo and you'll be taken to the subscribe page. And if you want to do some coaching with me, there's a little banner on the screen showing you how to go to my website and learn more about my long distance mental health coaching. And if you want to become a sustaining member of this channel, you can join a Patreon, become a patron of mine. And if you click on the Patreon symbol, you'll be taken to that website. And until we meet again, I wish you the best in your mental health recovery. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you.